Are social media companies going to be banned in India this week? The answer is actually not so simple. But I want you to stick with me because what's really happening is a lot more interesting and potentially a lot more impactful in the longer term as well. Today, I want to rope in IFF's legal counsel, Tanmay Singh, to shed some light on this issue. Will these social media platforms be banned and why are we even having this conversation?
Banned? No. See, 3 months ago, the IT rules were notified by the government, under which a lot of really stringent rules and regulations have been imposed upon social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, even WhatsApp. Now, the deadline to comply with these really stringent rules was yesterday. So a lot of people are concerned that being not in compliance with these rules will lead to these social media platforms being banned in India. But that's not how any of this works. Under the IT rules that we're discussing, there is no provision for banning of these companies.
Wait, so social media companies won't face any consequences for not meeting the deadline? What's the fuss about then?
There certainly are consequences, and they can be quite severe. Consider this. Facebook sees trillions of comments and stati on a monthly basis, and it can't possibly take legal liability for all of them. So it's protected by its status as an intermediary. Now, under these new IT rules, if Facebook or any of these other big social media platforms are not in compliance with the rules, they risk losing their status as an intermediary and could even face criminal prosecution under the IPC.
Okay, wait, so the government is saying that if these social media companies do not comply with the IT rules, then it can potentially strip them of these critical provisions that they need to ensure that they continue operating within India, correct?
That's exactly what the government is saying. Without intermediary protections, every time there is legal action regarding somebody's tweet or status, which is a trend that we're seeing more and more of these days, the social media company could be dragged into court. Cases are going to pile up. Imagine me using my phone to put up a post to my followers and Facebook being dragged to court.
Okay, so it's clear that 3 months ago, the new IT rules were notified. 3 months later, there's a deadline for compliance, which has now passed. And if these social media companies don't comply, then their operational environment is going to become so stifled that it may be difficult for them to continue operating in the country.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. They won't be banned, but the atmosphere may become slowly and increasingly so hostile that it may be impossible for them to practically continue in India.
So not only are these provisions problematic for social media companies themselves, but they also affect users of these platforms like you and me, in the sense that they undermine our privacy and our fundamental rights like free speech. Certainly, there might be some companies that simply comply with the rules. That's a good reminder for us Indians that, you know, these companies do care a little more about conducting their business and staying afloat and staying within the country, being operational, instead of standing up for the privacy and fundamental rights of citizens. However, some companies may also double down and fight back against these onerous rules. For example, the deadline was just yesterday, but it looks like from the news that WhatsApp has already moved to challenge these rules in court, specifically the traceability provision, because they feel like it'll be an end to your privacy. This should be really interesting.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how that plays out, actually, especially considering the government has taken WhatsApp to court, arguing that its 2021 privacy policy is not private enough. And WhatsApp is trying to take the government to court, reportedly, arguing that the 2021 intermediaries rules do not respect users' privacy enough. So who's going to win? Hopefully us, the millions of Indians who use social media every day. Now coming to the litigation that are pending, there are a total of 6 challenges as on the date of the shooting of this video, pending before various high courts of India. Now we at IFF are representing Live Law Media Private Limited in their challenge to the IT rules before the Kerala High Court. No interim protections or stays have been issued by any High Court against the IT rules, which means that they are presently enforceable in their current form. Before the Kerala High Court, we were fortunate enough to receive protection for Live Law Media against coercive action taken under these rules.
Tanmay, that sounds like a huge win for digital rights. But perhaps it's not enough just yet. What we really need is a lot more people to start looking at these rules from an, you know, constitutional lens and to engage in mass resistance against these stringent and onerous and unconstitutional, undemocratic new IT rules. government regulation is not a bad thing per se. But when regulation goes into the territory of government control and undermines your fundamental rights, that's when we as users and citizens have to stand up and advocate for these rights. So to the people viewing this video, please talk about the new IT rules in your circles, raise awareness, and consider donating to IFF, because our team of lawyers and experts is completely funded by your donations, and we're trying to champion this cause and stand up for your rights in and out of Indian courts. We could really do with your support today.